First, I'm going to show you how you can set up your scene and add some objects you will measure eye tracking data on. So this is the part of the software where you can set up and modify your scene called Inspector. You can access this by double-clicking on Build in SightLab. And here I have this model that I got off of Sketchfab, which if you're not familiar with Sketchfab, it's a great resource for finding 3D models where you can download over 150,000 Creative Commons free models. And so the first thing I usually do when I have an environment model is to double check the scale and where a participant will be starting from. And to do this, I'll bring in an avatar, which you can access from the resources folder. And where this avatar comes in would be the scale, direction, and location where a participant would be starting from, since the avatar starts at the origin point. If you needed to adjust the scale or placement, you could use the transform tools up here, and you would adjust them on the environment model and not the avatar. So if, for instance, the environment was too large or too small, then you would click here on the root node, which is the gear icon, and then you would use, for instance, to make it larger, the scale tool to where it's the right scale, or you would use these move transform tools and then click and drag on the arrows to move wherever you wanted to start in your scene. You can also see if you click here on this root node, it'll tell you the size of the environment model in meters. And so that's another way that you can go, and you could add the ratio of what you wanted to adjust this from to convert it to meters. And if there's not a gear icon showing here, then you could right click and do insert below transform, and then you'll be able to click on that root node. And once that's set up, you can delete the avatar model. Next, I'll add some additional objects, which I'll collect some fixation data on. You can look around the scene and collect data on everything, but these will be objects I'll collect some more precise measurements on. And to do that, I'll drag in a couple of more 3D objects, which I will just take from the resources folder here, and place them where I want them in the scene by just dragging them in. And now I'm just going to use the transform tools again just to move this object where I want it in the scene. So I'll place the guitar over here and then rotate it so that it's facing how I want it to face. And now I'll just add one more object. I'll add a crate, and then I'll place that where I want it in my scene. And now this next step is important for designating objects that you want to collect fixation data on. And for the software to recognize which objects you are targeting, you want to make sure these objects have what is known as a group node attached to them. And so most objects come in with the group node. If not, you can right click and go insert above group node. And then that way the software will be able to recognize these are the objects you want to collect fixation data on. And then you're also going to want to rename these objects to something that you could recognize, and you don't want the name to be something that's used anywhere else in your scene. So one good practice is just to rename your object and then use the tag underscore group, and that way you can make sure that it's not being used anywhere else in the scene. Now, if you want to do an area of interest, and so just a particular part of the scene, you can add in one of this fixation regions that are in the resources objects folder, and then place it where you want that in the scene, and then use the scale and move tools to be able to scale it up to where you want to fit over whatever area of the scene that you want to measure data on. And this is similar to how you would add something like this in a 360 video, which I'll show later. And then you're going to want to rename that as well if you want to designate what that area of interest is. And now the last step here is I'm just going to save this in my resources environments folder, and that way when I run the experiment, it will show up as an environment scene that I could run an eye tracking experiment on. I could go in and I could add lights or adjust the lighting, but since this scene has baked-in lighting, I won't need to do that. And so this is pretty much ready to go. Now I'll show you next how we can then run the eye tracking experiment and then afterwards go and view a replay with looking at the eye tracking data. And so to run this, I'm just going to double click on SightLabVR.py. If this is SightLab Pro or in the regular SightLab, you would double click where it says main, that shortcut. And then it's going to ask me to choose my hardware so I can choose from the various eye-tracked headsets like the Vive Pro Eye or I'm using the HP Omnicept, or I could choose non-eye-tracked headsets. And for those, it will just use head position for the analytics. So for instance, the Oculus, or I could run also a desktop mode that will just simulate an eye tracker. But I'm going to be choosing the HP Omnicept. And this is where I configure my experiment. So here I have some options I can choose from. So the first option is if I want to save a video recording of the session. And then I have the ability to select what the fixation threshold is going to be in milliseconds. Down here is where I will select when I do the session replay, where you replay this, what the avatar is going to look like. The next one is the environment model. So every model that I saved in the environment folder will show up here. And I'll choose from the drop down, and then I'll click configure, and then I will be able to choose which objects I want to collect fixation data on, whether I want to grab an object and interact with it, or if I want the object to be visible. And then I'll click done and continue. And now this is where I'll enter in my participant information and the ID number, which is used with the data files that I'll be saving out after I run this. And so now I'll click next. And now as I look around this scene, you'll see that green ball there is the gaze intersect point. So that's the point between my two pupils where it's intersecting with 3D models in the environment. So now I look over at this crate and I could pick this object up and interact with it and move it around, or I could teleport to different parts of the scene, pick up the guitar. And you could see that it's now showing in real time when I fixate on one of these objects over that threshold that I set for the fixation time. And now there's the area of interest, which is the bed. Now, once I'm done running this, I can first see a 3D gaze path visualization of where I looked around the scene. And now this is showing, again, the fixations and the timestamp. And so now if I close this, I'll be able to show you now the session replay mode, which I'll run the replay script, session replay, if it's SightLab Pro, or for the regular SightLab, that would just be called replay. And I could look at this in a desktop view, or I could also look at this replay in a headset and look at where I interacted and how I went through the scene. And I'm going to choose desktop and then choose which session I'm going to run. And so now up here, I can now look back where I looked at in the scene. So you see there's the gaze ray and then the 3D gaze path that's showing where I looked around the scene. And so it's going to show how I interacted with the scene and where I was looking. And then you have on the right some various metrics that you can toggle on and off. So that's the 3D gaze path or the gaze ray or the avatar. And then you have the timestamp and then also these fixation spheres, which will build up when you continue to look at one of the objects of interest. And I could replay this or scrub through the scene or pause and look around from different angles and kind of view this, and then have various ways of playing back and viewing what I did when I ran that session. And next I'm going to show you how you also have access to the raw data. And so here's the tracking data file. So this is showing basically a timestamp on the left and then the XYZ coordinates of the gaze intersect point and then the pupil diameter. And you could add additional tracking data to this file. And then you also will have custom flags that you can add. So for instance, if you wanted to see like when you fixated on one of these objects, what your pupil diameter was. So you can define custom flags, or as I said, you can add additional tracking data. You have an experiment data file, which will show you the amount of times that you fixated on one of the objects of interest, the total view time, the average view time, as well as a timeline of when you viewed each object. And then also if you had chose to collect, to save a video of the session, you would have a video recording as well as that interactive replay that I showed. And then also you could save the data files as a CSV file as well if you wanted to open it in a spreadsheet editor and, for instance, get an average of pupil diameter, do things like that. And next I'm going to show 360 videos and images and how that works with SightLab. So you simply could place your 360 videos or images in the resources media folder, and then they'll just be available. So you just simply drag and drop them in there. And then you double click on the SightLab VR 360 photo video, if it's SightLab Pro, or for the regular SightLab, you would just double click on the 360 video shortcut. And then similar to the other, to the 3D model one, you choose your hardware, and then you have your configuration menu where you can choose whether you want to, again, record a video of this session, and then whether you're running an image or video, and whether it's stereo or monoscopic, and then any of the videos you put in that media folder will show up in that list there. And then you again put in your ID number, and then you'll run this session. And now here, this is a session where that's actually me over there opening up our portable VR system, the Vizbox. And then you can see I have these, I have myself and the Vizbox designated as an area of interest. And then now when I stop this, I'll be able to go and see the 3D gaze path overlay again. And now I can also go and now view a session replay. Again, I could view that in desktop or a headset. And so then I choose the session that I'm going to be looking at. And now I can replay this with the overlay metrics. So I have the gaze intersect point. Now if I, again, press spacebar, and I'll see where I looked in the scene and see that 3D gaze path overlay. And then see where I looked in the scene, and then it'll show where what objects I fixated on. And then it'll show a fixation sphere if I look at one of the objects of interest over that threshold time that I defined. And then also I get the same data files. So I have the tracking data file that shows the timestamp and the XYZ of the gaze intersect point and the pupil diameter value, along with custom flags or other tracking data I might want to add. And then I have the experiment data file that shows the amount of times I viewed each area of interest and the average view time, total view time, and the timeline of fixations. And also, if you have SightLab Pro, you can access the code and you could do things, for instance, like gaze-based interactions. And so on these functions, like on gaze time, when it meets that threshold, you could have something happen in your scene, or you could set custom flags. So for instance, when an object is made visible, then you could have that appear in the tracking data file. As well as if you have an existing Vizard script, it's just a few lines of code to import SightLab and be able to access the functionality and add it to an existing Vizard script. And the last thing I wanted to show really quick is just a heat map. So that's another way of visualizing the data. And so it's run as a separate script. And so here you can see how that looks. And so I can look at which areas I had focused on, and I can adjust also the intensity of the heat map with the slider here. And so that's just another way of visualizing the data. And I also wanted to point out there's a multi-user version, so you could use this in a multi-user collaborative session with eye tracking. And also you can add a lot of additional hardware, like data gloves or full body tracking or things like that. And that's with the SightLab Pro. So that's basically just an overview of getting started with SightLab and SightLab Pro. And for more information, you can visit our website at www.worldviz.com or contact sales@worldviz.com. And also feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more information on our virtual reality solutions.